All right, today is Wes Day.
We eat snacks. W-E-S. Wes. It's a show. What we do on the show is we eat snacks. We discuss them.
And we read them.
It's the EDR system, and we're very proud of it. Welcome back. Some crazy times, Bexley. Some crazy times. A lot of exhaustion going on. A lot of...
I have a headache right now.
Oh, hopefully this makes it better. Yeah, it just seems like the world's kind of a crazy place right now. But we have snacks to bring us down to earth. What have you been up to? Other than getting student of the month.
Hugging Lorna a lot.
Aww, cat Lorna. And cuddling a lot.
And Gypsy. And River.
I wonder if the cats feel it. I wonder if they feel that things are a little off.
Yeah, because we're not out so much. We're not.
Maybe that's what it is.
And sorry if I'm speaking a little, with... Okay, that's better.
Okay, let's do this. Let's eat snacks.
Hold up. I love the thing that we're eating right. Because I love the Nabisco.
We had this conversation. Okay, it's a Nabisco treat.
It's, snack. The Go Packs. I love the Go Packs with, Chips Ahoy, Oreos.
Oh,
they're
nice.
Just great. It's nice. Nutter Butters.
Because you can just get in.
Yeah.
Get it. Eat. Yeah. Lowers the time from, gathering your snack to putting it in your mouth. You don't have to open anything and unwrap anything. You just put the hand in, grab it. Eat it, love it, live it. So let's introduce our snack. Today, we've got Ritz Bits.
I'm looking forward to these.
Ritz
Bits. I really am.
Friend to...
Did you just say Ritz Bits?
Ritz Bits.
You just said Ritz Bits.
I don't think I did, and we have the tape to prove it. And it's not tape, it's digital.
I love Ritz so much.
Ritz crackers in and of themselves are good. Cheese
I
is
like
hit or miss.
Sometimes.
Hit or miss, as we know with the combos.
The combos were very mediocre.
A little footy.
They were very mediocre.
A little stanky.
But sometimes I like cheese, sometimes I don't. Okay. Most of the time, it's 50-50 with me and cheese. Just cheese straight out of the fridge or something like that, I do not like.
Really?
Because, square cheese.
Oh, gotcha. Like American cheese?
No, yeah. American cheese is not
That's
good.
Not meant to be eaten on its own.
No, American cheese with anything is not good.
Really? Burger?
Not good. Only cheddar. I love cheddar cheese.
Gotcha. I understand that, and I respect it.
Cheddar cheese is great.
Agree. Although, I used to eat those square cheeses just straight.
Why?
I don't know. I liked them.
Why?
I wanted just a quick snack. Don't be mean.
But
don't judge me. You on your high horse.
You get the cheese out of the fridge. Oh, here. Just unwraps it, and then you just eat it.
Probably folded it in half. Probably take a bite and probably look through the hole.
Why? Do that with, lunch meat. It's better with lunch meat because lunch meat actually tastes good.
Agree to disagree, young man.
All right, let's pop. Oh. I love popping it open.
Jason.
Ooh. Oh my goodness, this is
so good. Go ahead and show viewers what we're talking about here. Can you smell it?
Yeah.
Not bad. Compared to say, okay, so if you go back to whatever episode that was.
Might give another 10.
If you go back to whatever episode it was that we did combos that initial smell from that cheddar was terrible.
I know. But this is just great.
This is good because it mixes with the cracker. And Ritz cracker is probably one of the best crackers, commercial crackers out there, if you ask me. We haven't covered it, but from personal experience, I think it's fantastic. Okay. You know what? I'm gonna let you take first dibs.
Oh, oh, oh.
Pick which one you want. Ooh, quality issue. We do have some falling apart.
That's great because I get to lick the cheese.
Interesting.
Off.
So we got it's a nice chunk of cat trying to get in. He wants to cuddle with you. Laura? Like. So we've got a nice chunk.
Oh, it's Casey.
Oh, what's she doing? Hey, baby. We've got a nice... Can you shut that door?
Yeah.
We've got a nice chunk of cheese here. That in... So the ratio is significant. A lot of times you just get the minimal amount. Say an Austin cracker with peanut butter. That was a minimal amount of peanut butter. What we have here is a proportionally significant amount of cheese. You ready?
Yes. Oh my god.
Yep.
I feel like the Ritz is overpowering the cheese. But the cheese still has room.
That's how you... Yes. You stole the words from my mouth.
Oh.
This is how you do a cheese cracker. You almost want it to be bigger so you can enjoy more of it.
I might have to give another 10.
So we've got, so the cracker itself is so sweet. There's a sweetness to it. I mean, there's a sweetness to the cracker, and the cheese comes in with a little bit of a sharpness to it to say, hey, let's have some fun.
I'm here.
And when you put it all together, so, so enjoyable. There's nothing harsh about it. There's nothing bland about it. It's good.
Oh yeah, this is loaded with cheese. We have to get more of this. Okay. We definitely have.
We have another one downstairs. So I'm gonna split it. I'm gonna sample the cracker by itself.
Oh my goodness.
A flavor I'm very familiar with.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
Ritz cracker.
There's a little cheese on it.
No. I'm gonna enjoy some cheese by itself.
That's great.
It kind of disappears. Weird consistency.
This is great.
That's pretty good. Pretty good. I'm gonna have probably 20 more before I can make my
I can have 20 more.
This is nice. I think we're really building it up. Man. Nothing wrong with this. Nothing wrong with a Ritz bit. My goodness. Whoa. Man. It's kind of an understated snack. I mean, look at that. It's just kind of like Ritz bits. Oh, it's fun because there's an explosive bit of cheese.
Yeah.
But, not unlike the Twinkie.
Ooh, it's that.
This thing speaks for itself. You eat the snack.
Huge.
You eat the snack, and you instantly respect it. You eat the snack, and it commands your appreciation. Again, doesn't need it. And that's where the respect comes in. I mean, this is great. This is great, but it's not begging me to like it. I'm gonna do one more. This is a long time for the viewers to watch us eat.
Yeah. Jeez, we've been working.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
You know what? These... You know what? I'm going to save that for my ratings. Speaking of ratings, shall we?
Yes.
Ratings.
All right. So we're back with ratings.
I'm going to let you start. For you.
I'm gonna go mega cheese blow.
From 1 to 10 cheese balls. Puffs.
Cheese puff. Cheese ball puff.
Whatever we do. What would you rate a Ritz Bits cracker? What is the singular Ritz Bit?
Oh, another 10!
We are on
how
a roll.
How many tens in a row? We've done really good snacks.
We need to go out on the limb and try some weird stuff, I think.
Yeah.
But
we have to do talkies.
But you're right. These are good. You know what? These could be...
Next to Gordon Ramsay of snacks.
So, in my estimation, I don't think this is a perfect snack. It's very good.
It's very good.
Very good. I enjoy it very much, as realized in my experience a second ago eating it. I do enjoy it because it's just a tasty snack, but it's not one I kind of expected it from Ritz because I've had them before. Unlike, say, you know,
combos.
What did I give a 10 to? Jello or pudding?
You didn't give a 10 to anything.
I gave a 10.
No, you
didn't. Oh, no, I didn't.
Yeah.
I didn't give a 10.
I never remember you hitting the buzzer.
The highest I gave a 10, or the highest score I gave was...
9.5, and that was for pudding, I think?
The pudding. And I gave a 9 to Twinkie? I don't remember.
You probably gave, like, yeah.
But I'm comparing it to that to because... Whereas I gave a pretty high score to Twinkie because it surprised me. And
yeah.
It blew me away. This is so good.
I know.
This is so good. But, you know, for Nabisco, it's kind of par for the course. They knock it out of the
park. Nabisco is one of my favorite.
They knock it out of the park.
One of my favorite snack companies.
They knock it out of the park every time. You know what Nabisco is? It's the American Gladiators.
Oh my gosh,
snacks.
Yes. Stop with American Gladiators.
It is the best.
Stop it.
Gladiators. And if it was an American Gladiator, it would be Nitro. Because he's the best.
How do you know so much about American Gladiators?
So,
that's the only thing you're watching other than Parks and Recreation.
All that said, this bad boy gets a 9.5.
Again, when are you going to give a 10? This deserves a 10.
I don't know.
No matter what.
Till next time, I'm Ben.
I'd love to.
See ya.